ಪುಷ್ಪ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ ನಂದನು ಗಿರಿವರ ವಿಂಧ್ಯ ಶಿರೋಧಿನಿ ವಾಸಿನಿ ವಿಷ್ಣು ವಿಲಾಸಿನಿ.
ದುರ್ಗಾ ಸಪ್ತಶತಿ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಸಾಧನ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ ಟ್ರೆಡಿಷನ್, ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಶಕ್ತಿ ತಂತ್ರ, ವೇರ್ ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಿನ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಎಸ್ ದುರ್ಗಾ ಸಪ್ತಶತಿ, ದೇವಿ ಮಹಾತ್ಮೆ ಆರ್ ಚಂಡಿ ಪಾಟ್, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಚಂಡಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ಸಾಧನ ಆರ್ ಚಾಮುಂಡಿ ಮಂತ್ರ ಸಾಧನ ವಿತ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ನೇಮ್ಸ್, ಬಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್. ದಿಸ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಮ್ಯಾನಿಫೆಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮಹಾಕಾಲಿ, ಮಹಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಮಹಾಸರಸ್ವತಿ. ಅಂಡ್ ದೇ ರಿಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ತ್ರೀ ಸ್ಟೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಆರ್ ತ್ರೀ ಗುಣ, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸತ್ವ, ರಜೋ ಅಂಡ್ ತಮೋ. ಸೊ ಮಹಾಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ ಈಸ್ ಅ ರಜೋ ಗುಣ, ಮಹಾಕಾಲಿ ಈಸ್ ತಮೋ ಗುಣ, ಅಂಡ್ ಮಹಾಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಈಸ್ ಸತ್ವ ಗುಣ. ಸೊ ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಶಕ್ತೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ವಿಷ್ಣು ಅಂಡ್ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದೀಸ್ ತ್ರೀ ಪವರ್ಸ್ ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಟುಗೆದರ್, ಇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಮದರ್ ದುರ್ಗಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಡಿವೈನ್ ಮದರ್ ದುರ್ಗಾ, ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಸಿಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಲಾಯ್ನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ಶಿ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವೆಪನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು, ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಶಿವ. If you see her hands, she has a, you know, Trishula, okay, of Lord Shiva. If you see her hands, she has a Japamala and Vedas of Brahma. If you see her hands, you see that Sudarshan Chakra and Shankha. Everything is present in her existence, in her form, to symbolically tell you that she has all the powers of ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ವಿಷ್ಣು ಅಂಡ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಇನ್ವೋಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪವರ್, ಹೂ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ವಿಷ್ಣು, ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಡ್ಯೂಟಿ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅರ್ತ್ ಆರ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಯುನೋ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್, ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್, ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನೆನ್ಸ್, ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಶಿವ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಫ್ destroying all the, you know, this world, whatever that is created, and again manifesting back into your consciousness. So these three forces are in one. These three forces are in one. So Divine Mother Durga is the one who is a creator. Divine Mother Durga is the one who is a sustainer. Divine Mother Durga is the one who can destroy all this. So these are the powers of Divine Mother Durga. So first, we need to have idea, okay, that is the power, and that can bring any type of transformation that I am seeking in my life. Is it clear? This is very important to understand. Whether my diet is powerful enough to solve my problems, otherwise again I am searching here and there. I am worshipping Divine Mother Durga, again I am worshipping Lord Shiva without knowing, out of ignorance. I am worshipping Divine Mother Durga, again I am worshipping Divine Mother Lakshmi. Is it clear? I am worshipping Divine Mother Durga, again I am worshipping Saraswati. So if I have an understanding that these three forces together forms one Shakti, what we call Adi Shakti. We call her as a Adi Shakti. If I worship her, means I don't need to worship different forms of her as a Shiva, Vishnu and Maheshwara. This is the first understanding we need to have. So that is where also you need to understand a little bit what is the importance of Trishula. So Trishula represents the transformation of Triguna. What are the Triguna? Sattva, Raju, or transformation of three state of consciousness, that is waking state, dream state and sleep. So if a person can transform these three states and experience the thoughtless state, what we called Turiyatita. thoughtless, a samadhi sthiti, where you transfer all these states of consciousness, then you are a person who can handle a trishula, who can able to or eligible to hold the trishula. Until unless that, you cannot. The Shiva is the one who could able to transfer all these things and raise himself into that Turiyatita or Shiva consciousness, a pure awareness, pure consciousness. So he could able to hold that Trishula. So that is given to Divine Mother Durga, means she is the having a capability to help you to transform all of this and attain the samadhi. To attain the samadhi. So when Vedas and Japamala is given to her by Lord Brahma, what it means? Vedas represent the knowledge. What type of knowledge? Not just material knowledge. It's the intuitional knowledge. What we called self-knowledge. So, once you worship, she has a capability to bless you that Vedic knowledge or that truth consciousness to you. That truth consciousness. When she is holding the Japamala, what is the representation of Japamala? She don't need to do the Japa, right? She don't need to do Japa. It is a representation of a mantra and Siddhi. It's a Siddhi. So, when you are worshipping, she has a capability to bless you, mantra siddhi. Is it clear? The success in your attainment. The success in your... So then, when she holds the Sudarshan Chakra, what is the representation of Sudarshan Chakra? It destroys all type of negativities. All type of negativities, whether it is a physical level, mental level, energy level, or astral level, even at the soul level. At the physical level, you might have enemies. Okay? Mental level, you have enemies. First enemy is your own negative thoughts. Then negative people or their comments, their energy that is influencing. Astral level, negative emotions. First yours. And people who are your relationship bringing you to experience the negative. Then a soul level, spirit level, where you will be influenced by any astral invisible beings who are attacking you, who are influencing you, who are, taking your energy, whatever that, tantric effects. So all these negative things can be removed with a Sudarshana Chakra. So Sudarshana Chakra is just a representation that she has a power to help you to overcome any type of enemies or negativity in your life. Is it clear? So Shankha. What is Shankha? It will create Om Nada. It will create a Om Nada. She can help you and bless you to experience that Om Samadhi, to give you that Anahata Nada, that inner sound of bliss, joy, pure awareness. Got this point? So she has all the power to help you in all fields of your life. All fields of your life. So, she, as a Durga, pure consciousness, when she become a dynamic consciousness, she herself become Mahakali, Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati. There's one source energy. We call it as a pure awareness, pure consciousness. And it is called a static energy. It's not having any dynamic movement. Okay? To make this static consciousness into a dynamic consciousness, you need a three forces. Ichcha Shakti, Jnana Shakti, Kriya Shakti. Is it clear? So, those Shaktis, what we called Mahalakshmi, Mahasaraswati, Maha. This is very important to understand. So, how the static consciousness become a dynamic consciousness. What I mean by static consciousness, for example, I am here with myself. It is static consciousness without any thought. The moment I got a thought, Ichcha Shakti, that I want to lift this paper. Ichcha Shakti. Ichcha Shakti. So that is in my consciousness. How it is going to be dynamic? How I am going to lift it? That is a Jnana Shakti. And then, Kriya Shakti. using my hand, I can. So this is what we called science of manifestation. Science of manifestation. If I want to manifest something in my life, I need these three shakti. That first I should have a desire, ichcha, that I want it. Then I should have a knowledge how to get it. Then I should know how to get this, what actions I should take, kriya. So a Durga sadhana, divine mother Durga sadhana, give you this sankalpa siddhi, give you the siddhi to manifest anything on this
earth. Janani roshini didi sutaroshini gurmada shoshini sindhu suti.